I'm a pediatric intensive care physician when I'm wearing my clinical hat. And when I'm caring for patients in the intensive care unit, one of the biggest struggles that we have is supporting patients through a critical injury or critical illness without developing a hospital-acquired infection. We have worked very hard to reduce rates of hospital-acquired infection and frankly have been very successful in doing that. But we still understand that patients whose immune systems are working poorly remain at very high risk for getting new infections. We take patients' blood and we remove it from their body and we put it in a tube that contains a stimulation solution. After incubation, we'll take the sample out and we will spin it down and take the supernatant or the liquid part and add it to a sample cup like this for determination of TNF-alpha. After performing our incubation, all we need to do is to take our supernatant that we have put into a sample cup, put it in the instrument, and behind it place one test unit. If I get a blood sample at 8 o'clock in the morning, by 2 in the afternoon, I can tell you how robustly the patient's immune system can respond to a new challenge. And since we now know what thresholds of immune function are associated with adverse outcomes, we can then identify patients that would potentially benefit from our GM-CSF therapy. And when you have something like a very serious traumatic injury, you can imagine it would be a big setback to have a new pneumonia or a new bloodstream infection that might potentially result in additional days in the intensive care unit, additional days on the ventilator, and just lengthen the time it takes for a person to get better. It is really our goal with the GIFT study to target the immune suppression that we have seen in the setting of critical injury and improve that so that we can work towards getting patients out of the ICU faster, getting patients off the ventilator faster, and have all of this happen free from hospital-acquired infection.